Let us discuss about the successive differentiation and Leibniz theorem. At first, we give some definition and notation. Let y be a function of x and denoted by y is equal to f of x. Then differentiation of y with respect to x is termed as first derivative of y a first differential coefficient of y a first derived function of y with respect to x and denoted by y1 a y dash a dy a dy by dx a f dash x a f1 x a ddx of fx a d of fx. Similarly, second times differentiation of y with respect to x is termed is second derivative a second differential coefficient a second derived function of y and denoted by y2 a y double dash a d square y a d square y upon dx square a d square of x a d of fx a f double dash x a f 2x a d square of x upon dx square. Continuing same passage. N times differentiation of y with respect to x is termed as nth differential coefficient a nth derivative a nth derived function of y with respect to x and denoted by dny a d d ke power n minus 1 y a dn y upon dx ke power n a y ke power n a yn a dn fx upon dxn a dn fx a fn x etc. Final definition gives us that the process of differentiation of process of differentiation of the same function again and again is known as successive differentiation. The derived obtained during this process count successive derivatives. For example, let y is equal to x to the power m. Then dy upon dx is equal to n x to the power n minus 1. And d square y upon dx square is equal to n n minus 1 x to the power n minus 2. So and so on. Now we have studied the definition of Leibniz theorem and proved it with the help of it, Leibniz theorems. If when we are two functions of x and y is equal to uv, the product of two functions, then nth derivative of y is given by yn is equal to un v plus nc1 un minus 1 v1 plus n c 2 u n minus 2 v 2 plus n c r u n minus r v r plus and so on u v r. And this theorem is statement of Leibniz theorems. We now discuss the proof of Leibniz theorem with the help of mathematical induction method, which says us that if it is true, phi n is equal to 1 and n is equal to m, implies that it is true, phi n is equal to n plus 1, that it is true for all natural numbers. So, at first, we have y is equal to u v, see equation number 1. Differentiating with respect to x, we have y1 is equal to u1 v plus u v, equation number 2, which is 2 for n is equal to 1. Again, differentiating 2 with respect to x, we have y2 is equal to u2 v plus u1 v1 plus u1 v1 plus u v2, which implies that u2 v plus 2 u1 v1 plus u v2, equation number 3rd, which is 2 for n is equal to 2. Let us consider it is 2 for n is equal to m. Then we have what? Ym is equal to um v plus m c1 um minus 1 v1 plus m c2 um minus 2 v2, so and so on. So on. MCR UM minus R VR plus so and so on MCGM means U VM. Equation number 4. Differentiating with respect to x, we have ym plus 1 is equal to um plus 1 v plus um v1 plus mc1 um v1 plus mc1 u m minus 1 v2 plus v and so on m c r u m minus r plus 1 v r plus m c r u m minus r v r plus 1 so and so on m c m u 1 v m plus u v m plus 1 using plus cons now MC R minus 1 plus MC I is equal to M plus 1 CR and arranging the terms we have ym plus 1 is equal to em plus 1 v plus m plus 1 c 1 u m v 1 plus m plus 1 c 2 u m minus 1 v 2 so and so on u v m plus 1 equation number 5 which implies that it is also true for n is equal to m plus 1. Hence, it is true for all values of m. Hence, the Leibniz theorems. Okay.